use your alternate hand to touch your toe. A few more, and then we're going to stretch out our hips. Okay, and then just looking behind you, stretch out your hips. You can do your toe touches if you want to. Chest behind, so you're looking right behind your shoulder. Okay, into squat, squat down, stretch up, touch those toes, looking in between your legs, stretching out those hamstrings. Come up, we'll do 10. And then we are going to start by doing a little bit of jogging on the spot, just to warm up, get the heart rate up, and then we're going to do 40 seconds of... We do each exercise twice over, okay? Just to keep it simple, straight, so once you've grasped the exercise, we do it over again. And we've got 10 exercises, and then we're going to do a little bit of core work for anyone that's still able to join us. If you aren't, that's fine. We'll just do the 10 exercises, that's great. And good enough, anything you're doing, just moving your body this morning is the most important thing, okay? Working up a good sweat. And if you can't do a move, just modify, jog on the spot, whatever it takes. Okay, and then a little bit of a jog on the spot. Get that heart rate up. Excuse my top, it keeps coming off at the shoulder, but there we go. I had to grab whatever I could this morning. It matches my mat, so that's the most important thing. Okay, so there's quite a bit of bouncing around, so I want you all to, you know, hold those pelvic floors nicely this morning. Okay, right. Are we ready? Steve's going to be using his weights, so you're more than welcome to join in with him if you want to grab your weights this morning. Okay, so using the timer, we are going to start with two sets of just normal regular star jumps, okay? Do each exercise twice.
That was 40 minutes.
40 seconds, okay, not 40 minutes. 40 seconds, but if you have to stop after 30, that's fine. As long as you are joining in, that's all that matters. Okay, ready?
Yeah.
Do you want to press it?
I haven't got weights. Yeah. No, it's fine. Ready?
Go. Okay, light on those feet so that you're taking the pressure off your knees. Bring those arms right up. Engage that core. Land lightly. Get control of the old pelvic floor as you bounce. Chest up. We will be using weights later this week. So if anyone that is a big fan of using weights, that's fine. We've got you covered.
Stop.
And stop. Okay. Quick rest, and we're going to do that round again, okay? Oh, I've got my water, thank you. Lovely. Okay. Ready?
Go.
Okay, everyone. Back on it. Star jumps. Lift those arms up, land softly, and make sure that you plant your entire foot into the ground as you come down. If you're on a mat, even better. It takes the pressure off your joints, your knees. Keep going. Nearly there. We're just gonna give this workout all we've got, okay? Set you up for the day.
Stop.
And stop. Okay, our next exercise, keeping it very simple this morning. Okay, our next exercise is high knees. If you want to modify, more than welcome to modify and just jog, butt kick, or march, whatever it takes. Just keep that heart rate up and keep moving that body. Okay, but for the rest of us, for those that don't want to modify, you're gonna bring your knees right up and chest up, okay? Ready? And go. Use those arms. Use your arms to give you a bit of momentum. Chest up. Keep your shoulders relaxed. Keep going. Remember to breathe. Engage that core. Who's giving it all they've got this morning? Hope you are. Okay, stop. Good morning. Massive wave to everyone. Morning, Lottie. Morning, Che. Morning. Give me a wave if you're joining in. Morning. Okay, right, we're going to do that round again, yeah? So, 2 seconds. Quick glug of water. Okay, ready, and go. I'll come forward. I'm aware of Steve's weight, so. Okay. Because I've been out of exercise for the last 5 days, I thought it's best to start with just no weights. If you've stopped for a while, it's always best to be careful. Don't just go back to the weights you were using previously, because you don't want to cause yourself any injuries. Obviously, 5 days isn't that long, but if you leave it any longer. But we will be using weights for a week, probably tomorrow. Keep going. Keep those knees up, chest up, use those arms, and stop. Okay, I hope you're all feeling nicely warm now, and your heart rate's up, okay? Morning, Kirsty, hope you're joining in this morning. Okay, our next move is going to be a side lunge, okay? So you're gonna go like this, come up, and then down to the other side. Hop, down to the other side. Hop, I kind of go off camera, so I hope you can see that, but nice side lunge with a little hop. Okay, so, I'm gonna do it over here so you can see what I'm doing. Ready?
Yep.
And go, so side lunge, stretch it out. Other side, little hop. You don't have to include the hop. But it gave it all of an extra kick. Really feel that stretch, okay? In your abductor. Feel that stretch because a lot of these moves are kind of transverse moves, so where we're stretching different parts of our body, most of them are frontal facing moves. So this is good because it's a side move. Working different muscles.
Stop.
And stop. Okay, we'll do that again. A few minutes, a few seconds. Okay, and let's go. Okay, so stretch down. Don't overstretch it. Nearly there, keep going. And stop. Okay. Next move is a pop squat. So you're going to squat, pop down into the middle with your hands and come back up, okay? Just make sure that you are really trying to push your bum out back so that you are not coming forward on your knees, okay? So take the pressure off your knees when you do this. If you want to do just a normal squat, that's fine as well, or a jump squat. Okay, ready? Let's go. So, down. Those legs quite wide, so more of a sumo squat than a normal squat. You balance and have your feet front facing, chest up. You should feel this in your bum. Then your quads. Stop. Okay. Big glove of water. Okay, I'm going to go back and do that all over again. That same move, okay? Ready? And go. Okay, so. Good. Legs into a sumo squat position. Bring those arms up, swing them up, engage the core, chest up, bum back as you land down. Feel this in your quads, feel this in your glutes. Keep going, keep going, almost there. And stop. Okay. Right. Okay, I'm gonna mix this up a bit. Right, we're gonna do burpee jacks. So with your burpee, you bring your legs just slightly wider than your mat as you come down, and then you're just gonna jump up. So I'll show you. So it looks like this. Come down, jump it out, legs wide, up. Okay, you don't even have to add the jumping jack if you don't want to. You've got a lot of jumps this session. Okay, right. Let's get into position. Ready? And we'll get just here. Ready? Okay, let's go. Ready? And
go.
Okay? So jumping out, star jump, out, star jump. I might turn those drive forward because I'm quite, this mat is slightly at an angle, but never mind. Keep going. You need to step it back, that's fine, as long as you're moving your body. Impressed with my coordination this morning. For a Monday, it gets pretty good going. Okay, we can do that round again in a sec, and then we're going to go on to mountain climbers. Okay. Ready? And go.
Go.
Back. Up. Start jump. Nearly there. Nearly there, nearly there. Keep going. And stop. Well done, everyone. Well done. Okay. So definitely a way to wake yourself up on a Monday morning, this workout. Okay, so we're going to do mountain climbers next. Morning, Joe. I hope you're joining in. I love seeing all your posts. I can never comment on them. I don't know why. Okay. Right, as you can see, Steve is already feeling it this morning. Okay, mountain climbers. Keeping it fast and ferocious this morning. And then as quick as possible so everyone can crack on, get on with their day. Okay, so people that want to step this one, they can. Otherwise, I'm going to run it. Okay, ready? Mountain climbers. Into position, bring your body weight forward. Okay, I think I should come slightly forward so that you can actually see it. Okay, slight angle. Let's try this. Ready? And go. So you bring your body weight forward. And you're just going to run or step forward. Yeah? Looking slightly in front of you. Keep those arms at a good 90 degree angle. Engage that core. You're running up that imaginary hill. Burning off those calories. Really burning off those calories this morning. Keep going. And stop. Okay. Do that again in a minute. So, everyone. My hair band's going up. Right. Back into position. You're going to do that all over again, okay? Really, let's burn off those calories. Everyone, ready, steady, go. Slightly in front of you. Keep those arms strong. Keep going. Almost there, keep going. Stop. Okay. I know I talk a lot about calories, but ultimately, this is also to help your mental health, because it's tough being stuck with family at home and all the homeschooling and everything else. So if you have released a few happy endorphins, that's definitely going to make you a better teacher this morning. So that's what it's really all about, okay? So on that note, let's get into the next move. So the next move is we're going to come down and jump up, down, so it's like a frog jump, okay? So we're gonna go down and up. So you're kind of touching the outside of your heel and then jumping up, okay? Ready? And if you want to modify, just step down and come up. Step ready. Down and come up, okay? Ready? And go. So down and jump up. More of an explosive move, obviously, if you add in the jump. But if you're just doing a sumo squat, that's fine too. Chest up. Oh, yeah. I don't know where the birds are this morning.
Stop.
And stop. Okay, we can do that again in a minute. Okay. Okay, ready? And let's go.
Good.
So. I know I look like a frog to most of you who are just watching this morning from your beds with your cup of tea. Joe, I loved your stones that you did. They were beautiful. Keep going. And stop. Okay. Right, next move I'm going to demo is big crawl. I'm going to squat down and you're going to kick. Okay, we'll kick. Okay, so squat into kick. Okay, squat kicks. Ready? Into position. Let's go. And for anyone that's watching at the stage, don't worry, we've got some ab work coming up that you are welcome to join in for. This move's good for all, everyone can do it. Good old kick. Really kick out. Oh, and the bin didn't arrive, which is a good thing. Not our bin then, but anyway. Go and stop. Right. Okay, we're going to do that all over again in a second. Okay. Right. Ready? Into position. Let's go again. Ready? And go. Squat. Kick. Squat. There was a reason why we hosted these at 8:30 as opposed to 8 o'clock in the morning. Keep going. Nearly there. Stop. And stop. Okay. So we're going to do two more exercises as part of this whole part of this exercise, part of this collection of exercises before going on to abs. So we're going to do squat kicks, which look like this. You can either step this out, okay, so you're going to jump in, jump out, jump in, jump out, okay? If you want to step in and out, that's absolutely fine as well. And you grab it up here. Ready? Ready, and go. Step in and out if you have to, otherwise bunny hops in and out. Looking just slightly out in front of you. Keeping those arms strong. Going. And stop. Ouch. You should feel that, okay? Do that one more time. Okay. Second from last exercise. Okay, right. Into position. Ready? Keep it strong, ladies. Let's go. Keep going, don't give up. Going. Almost there.
And stop.
And stop. Ow. Oh. Okay. Can't lift my legs. Okay, we're going to do one exercise. Okay. Then go on to abs. I know. Sorry, yeah. There you go. You need to turn the camera slightly, Lottie said, so we can all see you. I was doing some very serious, painful squat thrusts. I hope you all were too, okay? Right, we're going to finish off, actually, with another set of mountain climbers. And the reason being is because they will burn some nice calories. And if anyone's modifying, they can step them in and out, okay? I know we've done them. That's fine. Let's just crack on. Work up a good sweat. Ready? Into position. Finish strong. Finish in pain. Ready? And go. Keep that bum down. Keep looking out in front of you. Chest forward. Stop. One more round of those. Okay, everyone. Okay, just keep it going. The reason why I love mountain climbers is because they have least pressure on all your joints and things like that. Hold your arms strong and there's no pressure on your knees or any other part of your body. Okay, they get your heart rate up. Okay, so ready? This is the last exercise as part of this high intensity section of the workout. Into position. Let's go. Keep going. Keep going, 10 more seconds. And stop. Well done. Whew, my hair's getting everywhere. Okay, well done everyone for joining in that part. I hope you are sweating, like me, over here. Okay, as you can see, I haven't done any exercise for about a week. We're gonna go on now and do some core, okay, if everyone's got time. Okay, if not, cool off, shower, and have a great day. For those that are going to do a bit of core work, let's crack on. We're going to start with bicycle crunch. Okay, so quick demo on the mat. Okay, I'll bring the mat forward so you can all see me. I'm going to just do it quite vigorously. So on your mat, I'm just going to bring your legs up in tabletop position, and you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, engaging your core all the time, okay? Keeping your lower back on the mat. Ready? Into position. Yeah? Tell me when you're ready to go. Go. Ready? Go. 2. Just touching your elbow to each knee. Keeping it fast. Down the mat. Keep going. Remember to breathe. And stop. I'm going to do that exercise one more time. Have a quick sip of water. Right. Into position. Let's go. Thank you. stop. My core needs some work. Okay, right. We can do reverse crunch. Work on our lower abdominal. Okay? Good. I'm at an angle, but never mind. So if you see me sliding down, then that's because it's a slight angle here. Right, okay, but as long as you can all see, reverse crunch, this is what's going to happen. You're going to come up, and you're going to bring your legs up, and then out in front of you. Up, keeping your back on the mat, okay? As best possible, keeping your back. You're just working your lower core and your legs. Ready? Into position. Let's go. Up and out, reaching in front of you. In a controlled manner, you are in control of the move. Going and stop. Okay, you can all feel that in your lower abdominal. Very different feeling to the bicycle crunches, but we're working off on stomach here. Okay, we're gonna do that again. Ready? Into position. Let's go. Go up and cross. Stop. Okay, and stop. We have got two more exercises to do, okay? Everyone, I hope you're joining in. Right, we're gonna do crab, okay? So, from here, you're gonna come up, and you're gonna touch your toe, and touch your other toe, okay? Ready? Back on two more, okay? Okay, ready? Let's go. Okay. Up. And touching your toe. Feeling it in your core. Keeping your arms nice and strong. Stop. Okay. One more round of that. And then we're going to finish up with some toe touches. Okay. Ready? And go. Grab. Touching your toe, keeping those arms strong. Looking out in front of you, keeping your chest up. Reach across. Nearly there, keep going and stop. Stop. Okay, toe touches. We're going to bring. I'll turn this hand over to our toe. So you're going to come up and reach up like this. Okay, so with this move, we're going to bring both arms across from one side to the other. Okay, so I'm just going to demo. okay? So I hope you can all see that, okay? We're gonna do that for 2 rounds and then we're gonna cool down, okay? Ready? And in position, let's go.
Good.
Okay, do that one more time. Okay, on the mats, lying down, into position. Let's.
Straight through.
Let's just go. Ready? Go.
Okay, go.
Finishing up now, we've got homeschooling to be getting on with. Let's just crack on through with a nice, strong core. Keep going. Remember to exhale as you come up. And stop. Stop, 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 stop. That's a wrap. Okay, I hope you're all feeling well and good. Do post your sweaty selfies if you were sweating this morning. I'm going to do a cool down. Please join us for a cool down. It's really important to stretch out those muscles after a good workout. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, yep. Okay, so keeping your legs in a nice folded position. Okay, we're just going to stretch over, looking behind you. Stretching out your lower back. Two more. Okay, and then stretching your legs out in front of you. Just come forward and feel that stretch in the back of your hamstring. When you come down, don't worry about touching your toes, it's just about getting that stretch in the back of your hamstring. Stand up, and then we're going to touch our toes, stretched out. Looking in between your legs. Legs hip width apart, coming forward. Okay, and then grab hold of one ankle, stretch down again. Okay, and then into the center. And then to the other side. Back into the center. Okay, stretch up, grab one leg, stretch out our quads. So just bring your hips slightly forward, stretching out this part of your leg, your muscle. You should feel this in your hips a bit as well, in your glutes.